Being the people around me.
I mean, it's just to, don't, one, don't be hard on yourself. Don't try to be perfect right away because that will slow you down. I'll tell you that right now. What I would do is trust your instincts, trust what you feel like you've been called to do in life. God places things in your heart, not by chance, but because He has a plan for you. So, whatever that may be, even if it's a small seed of something, maybe one day you feel like you're going to be an entrepreneur. I'm just throwing that out there. You're going to have a clothing brand, and that's your purpose, or that's just the start of it. It branches off to much more, but that's where you begin, and then you take small steps and you don't let the distractions get to you, and you use that energy to, continue on that path. And then from there, everything will open up and everything will be more clear. If God told you every single thing that you're going to do, you might not even start the journey. So again, take every day, day by day. Take it day by day is my advice to you. Take it day by day. Win the day. Wake up. Ask God what you shall do. It could be just you working out today. Maybe He wants to get you in shape for whatever's to come. We don't know. All we know is that, every day you need to wake up and ask God, what shall I do today? And guess what? Everything will start opening up, God willing.
Listen, man, I really appreciate that. And Jay and Ryan, before I head out, just it means a lot that you guys would give people like me that don't really have a voice the opportunity to speak and be heard. Shit just made my day, and I can't thank you enough, man. Thank you.
Pleasure. Yeah, man. Have a good
Same
one.
here. Thanks,
All right.
Ryan. God bless you, Jay.
Yes.
Thank you. We'll go to Lila. I think Lila had her hand up next in the order.
Hi. Yeah, thank you. I just wanted to piggyback up on what Elijah was talking about, on how God is not only like a spiritual protector, but he's a physical protector as well. And it reminded me of this story. And if you guys haven't already, I encourage everybody in this space to go listen to the testimony of John Ramirez. He's a pastor. I don't know if you are familiar with who that is, but he was an ex Satanist, and pretty much he was, he goes and preaches about his testimony all over the world. And a story that really opened my eyes and caught my attention was he was saying Satanists and people that do witchcraft and all that stuff, their favorite people to attack were Christians. Because unfortunately, most Christians are lukewarm. We like to claim, where we have a relationship with God, but we still live like half foot in the world, half foot with God, and that's just not how it is. So since, Satanists, they hate Christians and hate Jesus so much, that's who they like to attack the most. And he was saying how he has many, many stories and times of how he would do witchcraft on Christians and it would work and they would die or they would get sick or, whatever would happen because they didn't have a strong rooted faith in the Lord. But he was saying this one time, this lady had came to him to, I guess her husband was like cheating on her with this woman. So she wanted to go to the pastor and pay him. At the time, obviously, he wasn't a pastor, but she wanted to pay him to kill the mistress. And so he said, okay, I'll do it for free because she's a Christian, supposedly. And him thinking she's lukewarm, he's doing all the steps, thinking it's going to work, gave her 21 days to die. On the 21st day, she didn't die. A month goes by, she's still not dead. So the John goes, and speaks with the devil and is like, what's going on? Devil says, you have to leave her alone. The God she serves said, we can't touch her, so we're gonna have to abort like this plan. And he was furious. He was like, why? Like, my reputation's on the line. And the devil gave no explanation to him. He just said, we have to stop, we have to leave her alone. And basically, that just goes to show you that your relationship with God is truly, it can protect you spiritually, yes, but physically, because
Oh,
this man
wow.
is used to doing harm, physical harm to people. That's his job. He would get paid. And the one time that he failed and he couldn't, do physical harm to this woman, it was because she had a real true relationship with the Lord.
Wow.
So that's what I wanted to add. I encourage everybody in here to listen to his testimony because he truly
Actually,
exposes.
it's actually interesting you bring up John Ramirez. John Ramirez actually prophesied to my auntie about me.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and John,
Oh,
I've
wow.
actually contacted John Ramirez, so it's actually pretty interesting that you brought him up. But yeah, I've spoken to John personally.
Oh,
Yeah, but
really?
that's pretty interesting that you brought that up.
Yeah, I've been watching a lot of his testimonies lately because he truly exposes like all
I'll
of
send
like,
I'll send
the
I'll send you the
workings.
video of him prophesizing to my auntie about me.
Oh yes, please. Like I would like to watch that. I encourage everybody to go watch.
Just so that you know, like that's how close, that's how small this world is.
Yeah, crazy. That is a small world. That's funny.
That's crazy.
And everybody, Eden Rocks here again. Eden, what's up?
Mr. Garcia, speaking of it being a small world, it's about to be a small dark world for a couple of minutes. I got my Eclipse goggles on. I got the Eclipse spacesuit. We're going to do the Eclipse Live. Not just joking. Don't look at the Eclipse Live, guys. They're saying it'll hurt your eyes. That's what people are saying. Not even joking about that. Hey, Mr. Garcia, I'm in the studio Friday. I'm cutting you the Ryan Garcia theme song. So,
please.
Yeah. I'll get that to you. Anyway, appreciate it. Right. Appreciate everybody.
Eden Rocks, guys. Eden Rocks. Back to us.
All right. Back to the Ryan Garcia show, sponsored by NASA. Oh, look at the Eclipse, guys. All right. Thanks, everybody.
Hey, order of hands right now would be Lala, Zenit, Relax, and Brock.
Okay, I can't remember who I'm piggybacking off of, but for me, the words of Yeshua are the most important words in any scripture. It's whatever Jesus said, Yeshua. He said,